and it happens at Talladega Super Speedway. Big flags in the air. Denny Hamlin, now he will proceed to block. He will get in front of whichever line he thinks is going to move the fastest and try to stay up front and dictate what's going to happen with this race. You're also going to hear drafting is already.
Christopher Bell. I believe it's Christopher Bell.
Yeah, sure enough. Bell around in the back of the pack. The eight also involved. And they're sliding down the banking. Caution has come out on lap one.
Like Christopher might have had a left rear tire go down.
Yeah, for the right rear.
The right rear.
Wow. Denny Hamlin in that 11 car. Chose the top lane. He was going to pick the bottom. The bottom has been the better lane on restarts. But look who's behind him. Two teammates. So he chose to stop at the top instead of picking the bottom.
Somehow or another, the 88 gets stuck three wide here in the center. I don't know if that was by decision, but it's that line not quite organized. They're starting to get together now. Right there.
He fell in front of the nine, his teammate, Chase Elliott, and there was an opening there. I'm not sure if that was Corey's strategy or not.
Right. That's pretty interesting, if so.
Rick, no one likes to see a caution out on lap one, but it might have been just the opportunity the 19 team needed to address an issue they were having with the radio. Have a listen. They got the issue fixed, but I'll go back up to the driver. Is that a place where you need your eyes and your skies or spotters? The radio is perhaps more important here than anywhere else.
Yeah. Whoa, I think cars get together behind this pack.
Oh. Sure enough, 47 is around, and he drives into the inside wall.
Yeah, Ricky Stenhouse, look at the front of this car. He had some damage. He had some damage already from that first lap wreck.
In an outside line. Three cars locked bumper to bumper. Only two locked up in that inside line and a shorter distance. Looks like two are going to get clear on the outside. Teammates side by side in the third.
What a Luckar, Matthew Benedetto. He's been telling us that he was supposed to be told last week at the latest what his deal is for next year. Does he have this ride or not? Is he racing for a ride today? If he is, expect some serious aggressiveness coming from that car.
Matt has said every time out, he goes out to give the best he can possibly give his team because he knows how hard everyone works. And he knows how hard he had to work just to even get to this ride. You see a pretty good push coming from the 22 there.
He's got his hands full on that 21 car, Dave.
I talked to Greg Irwin, the crew chief,
once again on the inside. Gets to the back bumper of Brad Keselowski in the two.
Look at that third groove up there. Kyle Busch, Austin Dillon, Eric Jones trying to recover after being shuffled to the back.
Are we going to see three wide for the win of stage one? It's building up that way.
12 car Blaney. These Penske cars are amazing pushers, and they're aggressively doing it, sending these guys into the lead. Right now, Buescher, recipient of some great pushes from...
And now coming up on three laps to go in stage one.
Alex Bowman to the outside of the 22 car, to the outside of Blaney, to the outside of the 17 now. Bowman getting help from the 22 car in the second place. Big run from the 22 coming. It's going to get in the back of this 88. 88 tries to go to the outside.
And rally go. Up in the air is the 18. The The 18 was airborne. It's the 88 of Bowman.
All guys that are battling for the points. Who did we just talk about a minute ago that decided to go to the back? Going to ride around. He also needed
points. Well, good job there.
Clint Bowyer saw this coming. Got out of it. He is going to survive this wreck.
With three to go, Alex Bowman is involved. Eric Almirola involved, and there's the 14 unscathed.
Big push up to the back of Bowman, and Bowman, this happens a little bit late, but Bowman was a little bit unsure of what to do to the inside, to the outside. He saw a little bit of a hole in the outside of the 10 car, tried to squeeze in there. The 10 of Eric tries to block it.
And the last time they went by, sure enough, it's going to happen. The green and white checkered flag is going to go out to Chris Buescher, which, by the way, this is his first career stage win. Chris Buescher in that Sunny D, number 17. On the outside line, Brad Keselowski. Discount tire number 2 on the inside. Two Fords leading the pack here at Talladega. As we get ready for the green flag, it comes back out.
That inside line's pretty tight. A lot of pushing the 8 into the back of the 2 car. That inside line coming up to the back of the 17. Chris Buescher got to clear easily. Top 3. That outside liner, Bill Drew, form up on the back straightaway, get a big run on these guys. Hard to happen.
Talk about cars with damage. That 8 car on the inside, row 3, involved in that lap 1 wreck. Got it there, got a bunch of tape on that car. Now he's got his way to the front.
Number 8, Tyler Reck, involved in an accident very early. And so he is running right up here, third on the inside line, and has been effective. He's been able to push, he's been able to run up front.
It's a long Chevrolet, though, and a bunch of Fords. There's about 4 Fords right there, and he's a sandwich. Cleaning up air to cool that engine.
And he's going to say, this thing has all of a sudden gotten faster.
And it drives better.
Oh, it's getting hotter. That's not good.
Morning. It's amazing what these spotters do at Talladega, Rick. They're almost an air traffic controller. Let's listen to Eddie DeHaan, the spotter for Chase Elliott, as he tries to keep the 9 car up front and his teammates behind him.
Still fighting for points and positions. The 62, Brendan Gaughan, his final NASCAR race was taking place, and he has severe damage to that car. You see the 1, Kurt Busch got up and on top of the 41 of Cole Custer.
Yeah, I'm good. Tell me the 22 has something to do with that.
You see the AMR safety team on the track. Take another look at what happened.
14 car has the 48 car out of control through the triable and gets into left rear quarter panel and turns the 48.
Yeah, right there, the 14 is pushing the 48. Gets him to turn around. Now, off the right. Kurt Busch way up in the air. Unfortunately, came down on his tires. There it starts, right there. That trial, we talked about it earlier, that is the worst place. That's where your car has the least amount of grip around this racetrack.
And remember, these race cars are 3,400 pounds, flying through the air like toy cars.
Move. 4 car breakaway out front. You made your
choice and now my chance is over. Now Truex, he's going to have to watch his mirror. He's going to have to decide which lane he wants to go.
You put me down and say I'm going nowhere. Leave the line back there. Jeff has the momentum. 38, though, gets to the back of this 8 car. Might push him free. Let's jump on the outside.
He's going to have help. Tyler Reddick in the 8 coming up behind him.
Yeah, that's great timing for Martin. The 8 car comes up there and helps him out a little bit.
Lost a little bit of ground right there, wasn't he? Was he keep up with Martin. Now he's going to get a big run. Will he push Martin? Yes, he's going to push him. There it goes. Get hooked up.
Oh, the 21's going to have a big run in the back of this 22 car. Going to have to lift a little bit. Here comes the 9. It's going to allow the 19 to get a run here. He's going to jump to the outside of the 17, to the outside of the 21. Joey's going to have to look in the mirror and decide what to do here. He's going to have to try to go block. No, he's going to stay low. Tricks could get to the outside here. He does.
Bunch up once again, and Truex out front. Will he lead the lap?
Certainly will. The 8 car team pushing into the lead. Now they're organized on the bottom. Trix is going to go down there and take advantage of that.
Had a few inches to clear Logano. He took advantage of it. Now he's got to control the race for that sandwich late block.
Almost sideways again, Tyler Reddick.
Truex is trying to block this 22.
And all the way down to the apron, the 21 has to go to avoid contact.
Oh, he's going to try to blend in. He does. No crash. Great work by everybody.
There's no penalty there. He did not advance his position when he went below the yellow line. He got pushed down there.
He's just trying to survive right there. Now Truex has got some work on this outside. I think he's going to dive to the inside here.
He does not want to push him. Tyler Reddick out front of Talladega.
Not quite clear what happens behind these guys. Who's going to push who?
Under 2 laps to go in the second stage.
Not enough help on the inside line. Reddick's going to fade. The 9 car is in position here to try to take this lead. Work around this 19 with some momentum off the back, off the nose of the 22. The 22 is behind the 9 car.
We know the 22 is going to push as hard as he can.
And they're all staying in line here. Pretty interesting.
Brad had a chance to jump on the outside of the 17. Didn't do it.
Oh, the 22 jumped out of line here. He's got an issue. For some reason, he's fading back.
Falling back quickly.
The 9 car is Lasky to the inside.
One lap to go.
What is going on?
I don't see why he would have.
Yeah, he's got an issue of some sort. Maybe his tire going down.
They were told over the radio to the 21 car as they get more action that the 22 is under penalty for forcing someone below the line, so he was not going to receive stage points.
Oh, there you go. Great call there. Great information.
Both receiving points, so get out of the wreck.
Finish it out here. Do not pay a green checker this time.
Look at how big this is. Big lead for Mark Trex Jr. with the shove from the 2 of Brad Keselowski.
There's a big run coming from the top. I don't think they can get there. 38-17. They're going to get this 2 car, I believe.
John Hunter Nemechek in that 38. But it's Martin Truex Jr. who wins stage 2. And with that comes a playoff point. Fifth stage win of 2020 for MTJ. Martin Truex Jr., winless on super speedways. He's up front, Brad Keselowski on that outside line in the 2. 63 laps to go for Talladega.
Line gain more cars as this race goes on.
about 9 laps to go.
Heart rates through the roof inside these cars right now.
And this booth.
Put up. On the 37 to the outside of 2. Put Brad Keselowski 3
wide. Just going up top lane. Just watch the top.
Lost it.
Hit the 90 mirror. Just put the top lane to 37. Going to run one back
in. Broke up the Penske's up front.
And now trying to slide into a spot.
Brad's trying to get into a spot there in the back. He's kind of taking a little bit of the organization out of the bottom groove. Well, that hurt him. There's only 4 cars together down there now. And now Joey has a whole new game plan. He does not have a teammate behind him. He's going to not be able to trust whoever's behind him. He's going to have to change his mindset here.
Bubba Wallace in control. 8 laps to go.
Bubba's going to try to block this 22 car. Going to help Chase Elliott on the bottom, but will there be enough cars left on the bottom? Oh, man. I'm nervous for Bubba. That 22 car pushing through the middle of the corner.
Keeps him out front. Now Bubba Wallace will be listening to a spotter looking in his mirror.
Watch this.
They're by half. He's still not clear.
What does he do? He's gonna stay with Bubba on the side.
Jump on the bottom. Worry about the top here.
He's pushing, physically pushing.
From left to your right here. Corner.
Right, the spotter saying, don't let him to your right rear. Do not let Joey Logano pass you on the outside with the message. Man, 22, can you push? He can push, Junior. That means he can get a big run. So when he wants to, he can turn left anytime he wants. Anytime he wants, he can pull out and go around the 23. Just get a little bit of a side grab.
Bottom's gone. Bottom's 5 back.
Joey right now is using his left side mirror, trying to see a run coming. Here comes a run. Big push from the Hendricks on the bottom. We're behind in the back of the 9.
Whoa! Big shove there from the 22.
3 back.
Joey could have made the move right then if he wanted to, but didn't want to.
Bubba Wallace out front, coming up on 6 laps to go from Talladega. He'll fall back.
Here comes the 2 Penske cars. Logano's going down to the middle. He's going to get to the inside of the 23 car. He's going to side drive it really hard right now.
First win, and it doesn't look like it's going to happen today. He's going to go to pit road, and a caution has come out. Talked about the spin. It was James Davison in this 53.
Well, that is an opportunity, though, for Bubba Wallace. His day's not over now. He's able to put on the caution.
Everyone else, too, that thought they might be short on fuel has an opportunity to save as much as they can under this caution and gain a little bit more of a cushion. Could have that green-white checker to delay this race.
11th caution, tying the Talladega record. Look at what happened with Bubba Wallace.
37 car Priest goes up here and gets into the back of him. Just a bad push there, not quite lined up.
Through the tri-oval. Green flag back in the air. All right. Overtime presented by Credit One Bank.
We got a tandem on both lanes right now. And I think that's what we're going to see at the finish of this race, unless they do get split up. They've got split up the 2, and the 22 are split up the 4, and the 21 of the Benedetto still tandem.
That's what happens at 21. Pulled the 2.
Make him out, Jim. Make him out, Jim. Make him out, Jim.
Now with the 21. He's got to make the 22 here.
I think he's going to tandem with the 22 now. Chevrolet's on the outside here.
Here comes Chase Elliott in the 9. A lot of speed, a big run. He had a huge push for the 24. Dives low, tries to get by. He's able to make the move, but he did get his 2 left side tires on the inside of the double yellow line. You can't pass below the double yellow line.
Finish line. Look who's in it.
Once again, Kyle Busch in the 18. The 4, Kevin Harvick.
Wow.
Look at the damage to that 18. What a day it's been.
We'll have to see if the caution did indeed come out.
They did not get the white flag, we're being told by NASCAR.
That means they'll try it again.
They throw the caution
and that's the worst case scenario for the 18.
They're gonna red flag it, so I guess not. I have no.
All that work to get the points they were going to get.
Yeah, frustrated Kyle Busch. It's been, well, as he's put it, it's been 2020.
What a very frustrating day for Kyle Busch. But you know what? They fought. They kept fighting. Kyle did his part. Team did their part. Kept themselves in the game. That's all you can do in these situations.
The 22, heavy damage.
Let's take a look and see how this happens. Oh, the 18 gets turned sideways by a push from the 8 car. Kyle Redding.
Team caught up in it, Martin Truex Jr. And a lot of damage there to that right front.
We've seen it all day, guys. The pushing from behind right there. And remember, Reddick has damage to his nose that may have contributed to it a little bit and how he was able to push the 18. Plus, the 18 had damage as well.
Yeah, the 18 car's got a ton of drag and a damaged tailpiece. And the 8 car, damaged nose piece, probably doesn't line up all that well.
Yeah, what you are out here, stop line's gonna roll here. Stop line's gonna roll, 22, let's be able to start out. Are you guys helping to stay? Keep coming. You got by the line, White.
Not being able to pick up fuel running around pace laps.
And if you run out of fuel in front of the field, obviously, that's opportunity for a great big wreck.
So I had to flip it. Copy. Just do the best you can here.
You heard that. I had to flip it. Already has gone to the reserve.
That means he's probably only got maybe a lap.
That was Chase Elliott in the 9. Green flag back out. Overtime for Talladega. Into the wall, and the caution has come out. There'll be a third overtime.
Bubba went up there to try to get the momentum from that high side, but it disorganized, and then he was trying to find some energy off any car he could find behind him. Kelly, what do you got on the 43 car?
Yeah, Bubba Wallace, what a disappointment after he had such a strong run at times today. He said, oof, that one hurt, I think physically and probably a little bit emotionally, but obviously he's okay unstrapping himself, getting ready to climb out of the car. But man, what a disappointment for Bubba Wallace.
Yeah, and Ryan Blaney right behind him. Those two guys are best friends. And not the way they wanted this race to end. That was a big hit for Bubba Wallace. You see him stretching his back there as he climbed out of the 43. DiBenedetto on the inside. Does he have enough fuel? Does the guy pushing him? Right behind have enough fuel. And Denny Hamlin, we know he's got enough fuel to come back through the restart zone. 2 laps to go for Talladega.
Both lines are organized.
Pusher pushing. DiBenedetto out front now. 3 car
advantage. Bottom advantage. 17, 24 clear.
Pusher continues to push down the back straightaway. Locked up in tandem. They're getting away. Can they stay in tandem? They almost have to now.
Brothers and Matt DiBenedetto out front at Talladega.
No organization right now. Look at this outside line. Oh, we got a car on the wall, the back straightaway. Cody Ware. Here comes the 17 and the 24. They're going to try to block.
Eric gets over the wall. Now the 24 on the big run. He slides. They make more contact. Three wide as they come out of four.
Hamlin to the inside. Side draft coming from the 24 car.
Denny Hamlin. William Byron. Through the triangle coming up to the stripe. And as they go across the stripe, a photo finish. Denny Hamlin gets the nod by 23 one-thousandths of a second.
No way. And Matt DiBenedetto has no clue until he gets the information from his team that he again is going to come up short.
Denny Hamlin was on the apron.
After the crap we've been through the last several weeks, like I said, keep putting yourself in position, we'll win our share, right?
Denny Hamlin, take a look at this. How close it was.
He's clearly ahead at the line. Tough situation again for Matt DiBenedetto, almost to get his first win. He'll have to try another day.
Seven wins this season for Denny Hamlin. It's his 44th career win. Why is that important? It ties Bill Elliott.
How did you pull this win off, Denny?
Just a lot of attrition. I mean, we just played the strategy, the numbers game to run the back until we were locked in, but it just, things worked out. We finally got one back. Like, you know, we probably, this one was unexpected to say the least, but probably this whole FedEx team, Toyota, everyone at JGR for bringing great race cars. And today we're obviously thinking about JJ D'Amato and his two kids. So really, really excited about this win. This is unexpected for sure.
Yeah, JJ, certainly a big part of Joe Gibbs Racing. Denny, I got to ask you about the pass for the win. You had to go below the yellow line. Were you aware that you'd kind of been forced down there? And the take on that, going below the yellow line to be able to make the pass for the win.
Yeah, well, they were crashing in front of us, so it was, you know, obviously I got forced down there just like I think the 21 and others did. So, yeah, there was a bunch of us that all crashed down there.
In this process, you tie your hero, Bill Elliott. How much does that mean to you, Denny?
So much. I mean, he was my childhood hero growing up, and so that's why I've always been number 11, to be honest, is the days he was running for Junior Johnson. So just an amazing day.
Matt, you know, a lot of people think maybe you should have won today. What do you think?
It was just a crazy finish. I haven't even been able to really process it. I'm just really want to get this thing in victory lane. Menards, Tuscany Fawcett's team. Oh, sorry, the emotions from, God, I feel like it's the same story. A lot of times, just heartbreak. My wife and I have had a stressful week again. You know, just not uncertainty. Fighting, my whole career is a fight for my life. But I'm so appreciative of this team, the Wood Brothers. I want this 100th win for the Woods so bad. Our alliance with Team Penske, Ford, I mean, I appreciate them. Put me in this car. It's so much fun to drive and have a shot to win. And Denny did a great job. Deja vu, holy cow. But no, Denny, I mean, he deserves all the support in the world. He's an incredible racer. He was my biggest threat. I tried to block all I could. My spotter, Doug, did a great job. And just, this is tough.
Deja vu from Bristol last year, Matt. You led in the restart.
It was actually tough to see. My windshield was filthy from all the speedy dry. I was having trouble seeing the block. I was blocking everyone's lane. That was pure desperation. That's how I drive every race, every time I ever step foot in a race car. I'm appreciative for the challenges I face, because that's what it teaches you when you have those shots. I just wanted so bad for my team, Greg Irwin, all these guys. But wild, wild finish. That's Talladega. I'm glad the fans got a great show. I hope to win races. I know we can do it.
These battered hands are all you own. This broken heart that's turned to stone. Go hang your glory on the wall. There comes a time when castles fall. And all that's left is shifting in the sand. You're out of time, you're out of place. Look at your face, that's the measure of a man. This coat that fits you like a glove. These dirty streets you learn to love. So welcome back, my long lost friend. You've been to hell and back again. And God alone knows how you crossed that span. Back on the beat, back to the start. Trust in your heart, that's the measure of a man. Now you can lose, now you can choose. That's the measure of a man.